Hi, MOVATI members. My name is Francine. I'm going to be guiding you through a 30-minute yin class. You will need a couple blocks or a couple books that can act as blocks and a bolster or something that can act as a bolster. It might also be helpful if you have something to cover your eyes, so an eye mask or a towel to go over your eyes for savasana. Optional to have a blanket to cover yourself up for savasana as well, so you can get nice and cozy. We're going to begin in a child's pose today. So take the knees wide and the toes together. Sink the hips back towards the heels and walk your hands out in front of you as you allow your chest and your forehead to sink towards your yoga mat. Bring your awareness to your breath. Focus on your inhales and your exhales. Breathing into the backside body, feeling your entire torso expand 360 degrees with your in-breath. Allowing the body to soften with each out-breath. We'll be holding each of these postures for about 3 to 5 minutes. So allow yourself to settle in. Find stillness. And surrender into gravity. Option to place a block underneath your forehead if you need to bring the earth a little bit closer to you. Honoring stillness. And this time and space that you've given yourself just for you. Send your breath to wherever you feel this posture. Child's pose is an incredibly humbling posture. Feel yourself being supported by the earth beneath you. Allow this posture to nourish your body. Let's take about 10 more deep breaths right here. Practicing with attention and intention.
Notice how the inhales create space in the body. Exhales create heaviness, softening. Three more breaths. And after your last exhale, taking your time, your next inhale, walk up onto your hands and walk them back towards your hips.
Take a moment here, just sitting on your heels. And we'll roll up the edges of our mat to come into frog pose, adding a little bit more cushioning for our knees. You can play with the distance that you'll have your knees from each other. So setting up the mat to an appropriate depth, and then taking the knees on this nice cushioned edge of your mat, 90 degree bend, ankles in line with the knees, also at 90 degrees, feet flexing towards your shins, and then maybe bringing your forearms down onto one or more blocks, sinking the hips back towards the heels, and maybe closing your eyes and settling in. We'll be here for a few minutes. We typically hold these yin postures anywhere from 3 to 5 minutes. Usually it takes about 2 minutes before the muscles start to let go and we can start to stress the connective tissues of the body, the yin tissues, our fascia, joints, ligaments. Let go of any expectations for your practice. Let go of whatever you think this posture is supposed to look like and focus a little bit more on how it feels. If frog is a little bit too much for you, you can take yourself into tadpole by taking the toes together. Knees will stay wide apart. Bring your awareness back to your breath. And start to tune into the subtler sensations in your body. Notice whatever shows up. Thoughts, feelings, sensations. Just simply observing without judgment. Notice how nothing is permanent. Any thoughts, feelings, sensations, they're all temporary. Send your breath into your hips. We're about halfway there.
Over time, the body may invite you to go deeper into this posture. Resist the urge to force, to push, to pull. Simply allow. Surrender into the posture rather than trying to get the posture to land in the body.
Five more deep breaths.
Last inhale. Exhale to stay. Inhale, begin to glide forward a little bit. Take the toes to touch.
Take your time walking up onto the hands and slowly taking the knees back together. Find tabletop. Drop the belly, take the gaze forward. Exhale,
round the spine. Push your yoga mat away from you. Tuck your tailbone.
Inhale, cow. Lengthen, extend. Exhale, round. One more, inhale. Exhale, contract. Inhale, neutral spine. Exhale, walk your hands back towards your hips. Sit on your heels. Place your hands on your thighs. Unroll the edges of your yoga mat. Roll onto your right or your left bum cheek. Swing your legs out in front of you and take them wide for straddle. Place your hands behind you next to your hips. Inhale, reach the crown of your head up towards the ceiling. Exhale, tilt your pelvis forward and begin to walk your hands out in front of you. Being mindful not to round the spine if you have any issues with your back. Otherwise, once you come to that place where you feel a little bit of resistance, you can begin to round your spine, tuck your chin, allow the head and shoulders to become heavy. Maybe you come onto your forearms. Maybe your forearms come onto blocks. If you take the palms facing up, you can resist the urge to force, to push, or to pull. Close your eyes and soften here. Notice if your mind starts to wander away from the four corners of your mat. See if you can bring your awareness back to your breath. We're just a little more than halfway there. Stay a little bit longer. Last five deep breaths. After your fifth exhale, without any rush, inhale to walk back up onto your hands. Walk them back towards your hips. Exhale, turn your navel towards your right toes. You can place your right forearm to the inside of the right knee. Inhale to sweep your left arm up and over your head, reaching towards your left toes. Just adding a little bit of a twist.
breathing into the left side body, creating a little bit of space in between your side ribs. Breathing into these intercostal spaces. They're so hard to target sometimes. Try to get your bicep right over your ear. Know that closing your eyes is the first sign of relaxation. Few more breaths on this side. On your next inhale, come back through center. Exhale, turn towards your left toes. Take your left forearm to the inside of the left knee. Inhale, float your right arm up and reach it towards your left toes. Breathe into your right side body. 1 minute on this side. Last breath in, last breath out. Inhale, bring yourself back through center. Exhale, place your hands behind you next to your hips. Drag your heels towards your body. Extend your legs straight out in front of you and just lean back for counter pose. Inhale, come back through center. We're gonna set up for half camel. So we can take our bolster and or our blocks. Half saddle, if I said camel. I just taught a couple classes where we did a lot of camel. So I think I'm gonna stick with just blocks for myself. We're gonna take the right knee and bend that so that the toes are pointing out towards the right. You can play with the height of the blocks. If you need a little bit more support, you'll have it on the highest height setting, or the medium height setting, I should say. The highest height setting is probably gonna be a little bit too much. Again, or you can play with one or two pillows, whatever you need to support yourself here. And on an exhale, start to lean back. And you might just stay right here, and maybe this is enough. If you can go a little bit further, you might make your way onto your forearms. And for some of us, we might even come to lay flat on our backs. But it's nice to have a little support. It's okay if the right knee lifts. And again, you could play with the block so that your head is resting on that. And you might even shift yourself a little bit over to the left side of your mat so that you can get that right knee, right ankle on your mat. Sometimes the ankle likes a little bit of cushioning. And start to settle in. Take your arms wherever feels good. Come back to your inhales and your exhales. Really working the hips today. This is where we hold a lot of our personal stress.
They're like the emotional junk drawer of the body. We tend to stuff all the emotions that we don't want to deal with into our hips. So that's saying that our issues are in our tissues. It's where that comes from. And when we work through these yin postures, we can work to clear not only these physical but energetic blockages in our body. Try to create an exhale that's twice as long as your inhale. Maybe pausing at the top of the inhale. Pausing at the bottom of the exhale. And know that feeling some discomfort is normal, but you shouldn't be feeling any pain, pinching or numbness. Those are all signs that you've gone a little bit too far and you need to back off. For some of us, we have sensitive knees, so please be mindful and listen to your body here. About five more breaths on this right side in half saddle. Last breath in, last breath out, empty completely. Take your time, walk back up onto your hands, and using a little help from your right hand, we'll take that right leg out in front of us, and we'll bend the left knee. Maybe shifting a little over to the left side of your mat. And when you're ready, start to lean back. Three minutes on this side. Breathe into tension, breathe into discomfort. Noticing the differences between the right and the left side of the body without attaching any meaning to it. Noticing if your eyes are open or if they're closed. And if they're closed, just maybe asking yourself why. No need to make anything right or wrong. Just observing, just getting curious. Just a little more than halfway there. Thank you. last 5 breaths. Notice if there's anywhere you're holding on. Give yourself the permission to let go. Last inhale. Exhale to stay and maybe soften a little bit more. Taking your time. Walking back up onto your hands. Using your left hand to help extend the left leg out in front of you. Bringing your blocks with you as we come to lay on our backs. We'll probably want that block that's going to land under our head on the highest setting, or perhaps the medium setting, and the medium setting for a block that's going to land between our shoulder blades. Take your hands so you can help guide this block to land between your shoulder blades, and you may need to play with the location of the block so that it supports your head. If this is a little too much, you can put it on the highest setting. If you'd like to go a little deeper, open the throat chakra a little bit more, you can put this block on the lowest setting. Arms alongside your body, palms facing up. Take the soles of the feet together and allow the knees to fall open like a book in reclined butterfly. Come back to your breath. Feel an opening throughout your chest, your heart space. Feel an opening through the groin, the outer hips. Option to place your left hand on your heart, your right hand on your belly. Close your eyes or soften your gaze. Take your awareness inside. Now you have the option to come off of your blocks to come into your savasana, or you can stay right here, yogi's choice. If you're coming off of your blocks, just roll over to the right or the left. Remove the blocks from underneath you. You might even take a block under each knee, setting yourself up for a really sweet savasana, taking the legs mat width apart, feet falling out to either side, arms alongside your body, slightly away from you, allowing the armpits to breathe. Or you can take your left hand to your heart, right hand to your belly. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Maybe you take a towel or an eye mask over your eyes to help darken the room. Feel the rise and the fall of your breath. Feel the beating of your heart. You can stay in savasana as long as you wish. Try not to move a muscle. Surrender completely here. If you have more time, you can stay exactly where you are. Otherwise, on an inhale, reach your arms up and over your head. Point your toes towards the front of the room. Take a full body stretch. Remove any blocks that might be in your way. Exhale, draw your knees in towards your chest. Roll over
onto your favorite side of your body. Pause here for a breath. And then take your
time to push yourself up into a comfortable seated position. Taking your palms to touch at your heart center. Bowing your chin towards your chest in gratitude. Know that everything that you just did on your mat was exactly what you needed. Inhale your thumbs up to your forehead center, sitting up even taller. The light in me sees and honors the light in each and every one of you. Acknowledging that we're all one, we bow forward together and say,
Namaste.
Thank you so much for joining me.